What exactly are gravitational waves, and how do they reveal the untold stories of our cosmic past? But before we delve into the intricacies of gravitational waves, let's take a quick look back at one of the most iconic discoveries in astronomy history, the cosmic microwave background. This ethereal glow, born from the aftermath of the Big Bang, serves as our cosmic time capsule, offering glimpses into the very origins of our universe. Yet, as fascinating as the cosmic microwave background is, it only scratches the surface of our cosmic curiosity. To truly understand the dawn of time, we must turn our attention to the subtle whispers of space-time itself, the gravitational waves. So buckle up and get ready to explore the wonders of the cosmos like never before. And hey, don't forget to hit that like button. In 2023, scientists at NanoGrav made a mind-blowing announcement. They may have caught a glimpse of something extraordinary using a clever method. By using exotic stars like cosmic listening devices, they detected the subtle vibrations of space-time itself. These gravitational waves hum might hold the echoes of the universe's birth itself. Today, let's dive into the mysteries of these massive gravitational waves and the brilliant method astronomers used to find them. Gravitational waves play with the fabric of space-time, causing light to take longer routes through tunnels. It's like a cosmic dance that stretches and squeezes the very essence of space itself. Devices like LIGO are picky listeners, tuned into only a specific type of gravitational wave. Just like how there are different pitches in music, gravitational waves come in various frequencies. LIGO is like an orchestra conductor, only hearing the high notes. Imagine two massive objects spinning around each other rapidly, like dancers before a grand collision. That's when LIGO's ears perk up. But it misses the earlier, quieter stages when they're farther apart, producing softer, lower-pitched hums. These slower orbits create faint hums of gravitational waves, unlike the loud bangs of close collisions. It's like a serene symphony, where each note blends together into a harmonious melody. Bigger black holes play a major role in this cosmic signal. The most noise comes from pairs of supermassive black holes, those massive ones you'd find at the heart of galaxies. These duos are a big deal. They're made of black holes billions of times heavier than our sun. But they're quite rare because they only show up when something epic occurs, the union of two galaxies. When galaxies come together, they mostly glide through each other due to vast spaces between stars. Actual star or planet collisions are super rare. Instead, stars attract one another, merging into a single galaxy. At the center of these merged galaxies, you find supermassive black holes. They form pairs that keep circling each other long after the galaxies join. These leftovers from galactic mergers produce the strongest signals, especially at super low frequencies, like the nanohertz range. Just like how we can't hear low sounds, LIGO can't pick up these cosmic vibrations. But if we could, we'd unlock secrets about galaxies and black holes. And that's not all. The gravitational wave background offers a peek into the universe's very beginnings. Let's quickly go over what we know about the cosmic microwave background. This microwave light is the oldest light we can see because, at first, the universe blocked out all light. What does it mean for the universe to block light? At first, it was too hot for neutral matter. Electrons and protons couldn't stick together to form neutral atoms because they had too much energy. This hot stuff, called plasma, filled the universe. Light got stuck in plasma, bouncing off charged particles. But as the universe cooled, protons and electrons formed neutral atoms, and suddenly, light could travel freely. This light was then stretched by the expansion of the universe until it read shifted into microwave light. This is why the cosmic microwave background is the earliest light of the universe. But gravitational waves are not made of light, they're made of space-time itself. Plasma is no obstacle to them. To gravitational waves, the universe has been transparent from almost the very instant of the Big Bang itself. They can penetrate past this plasma barrier and offer us a glimpse of the very first moments of the universe's creation. Because these primordial gravitational waves have been traveling for so long, even if they were originally produced with a high frequency, they would be greatly stretched by the expansion of space-time. They would be redshifted into ultra-low frequency gravitational waves, the same kind that would come from black hole binaries. Together, these multiple sources will give us a so-called stochastic gravitational wave background existing over a range of low frequencies. How can astronomers retrieve this treasure trove of information about black holes, the Big Bang, and more? Can we build a better LIGO and detect how the Earth is bobbing up and down in these gargantuan gravitational waves? Well, LIGO works by sending two beams of light being sent along perpendicular tunnel arms. The beams are reflected by mirrors at the ends of each of those tunnels until they return to the starting point and are compared with each other. This is so that if space-time gets distorted along one direction, the information from the other direction can be used to get a sense of how much it has changed. Unfortunately, if we were to design a new LIGO to detect these gravitational waves, we would need it to have tunnel arms that are much larger than anything we can build on Earth. This is because the frequency of a wave is inversely proportional to its wavelength. Ultra-low frequency waves will have an ultra-long wavelength and would require us to look at the changes over a much greater distance to notice the effects of these gravitational waves. In simple terms, nanohertz waves complete one full cycle every billion seconds. Calculating the wavelength, which is the distance between wave crests, involves dividing the speed of the wave by its frequency. For nanohertz waves, this results in an incredibly long wavelength of around 10 to the power of 17 meters. In conclusion, the vastness of space and the mysteries it holds continue to captivate our imagination. As we've explored in this video, the challenges of understanding phenomena like nanohertz waves remind us of the immense scale of the cosmos. But our journey doesn't end here. There's still so much to discover and explore beyond our current understanding. By staying engaged with our channel, you'll have the opportunity to dive deeper into the wonders of space science. So, I invite you to subscribe and join our community of space enthusiasts. Together, we can embark on a thrilling adventure through the cosmos, uncovering its secrets and marveling at its beauty. Don't miss out on future content that will expand your knowledge and ignite your curiosity. Hit that subscribe button and turn on notifications to stay updated with our latest videos. Thank you for watching, and until next time, keep looking up at the stars.